Sean todos bienvenidos al canal hoy. All welcome to this channel. Today we'll talk about Other Amstrad. What is Other Amstrad? White Ranger.
Other Amstrad means the other Amstrad that nobody wants. There is a lot of other models of Amstrad that Alan Sugar sold. For example, they were quite successfully in Europe. Because they are the low prices that he got with his computers. For example, the model, the PC compatible modes were very successfully, at least for the amount of computers you can see in eBay these days. The PC, in this case, we have two models. The PC
1640.
1640
HD 20. What is PC?
It's an 8086 compatible PC. We have 640K of RAM. The model come with two options. You can get it with a monochrome monitor or with a color monitor.
But
it has several features that make it unique in the world of PC clones.
But before we see this computer, we'll see another computer. We see here in the cam computer. What this computer?
This model is the Amstrad PCWB, the A256. It has 256K of RAM in the default model.
Okay.
This one is expanded to
it's for the year 85,
yeah.
Right?
This was sold with a printer. I don't have the printer connected at the moment. I use it for anything, but this was a word processor system.
Yeah.
You can see in the name. In this case, this model was for the Spanish market and say procesador de textos.
Decirlo en español, procesador de texto.
Tiene procesador de texto.
Have a word processor, right?
Yeah, yes, it was used almost exclusively to do text. Alan Sugar got this idea because what most people at the time do in a serious manner, apart from playing games at home, was doing text processor for school or work.
It's a computer for a work and for education, it's right?
Mostly, in reality, it's mostly for home and a small business.
Yeah,
it was very cheap at the moment with the printer. It was probably the cheapest setup you can get for a word processor at the moment. And also, this computer runs CPM.
Yeah, we have in this computer two operation systems, right? We have a basic and we have CPM.
No, no, no.
No? Why?
This because this have no ROM on it. There is no if you remove the floppy and you power on this thing, you will see that there is nothing.
Okay.
It will ask for a floppy, making the grinding noise with your floppy drive, and the screen will flicker and will beep now because there is no floppy on the drive.
So this computer don't have BIOS.
This computer don't have any ROM on the motherboard, and that was something that the engineers at Amstrad were very do in a very bizarre fashion, because the a few instructions for the CPU are embedded on the main ASIC on the motherboard. I got you a picture from the motherboard.
I look this the technical information and I see they have the same C-log.
This runs CPM because it has 780.
Yeah, and I see another interesting thing is the price of the computer in that year. Because this computer sold too much is for the price, right?
Yes, it was a complete system. You get the monitor, floppy drive, keyboard, and the printer. All in one.
A British language come for your mouth. Let's take a look at the computer and some software for this. What software come for this computer?
Well, mainly text processor. We'll just take the locomotive software processor that was included with the system.
Yeah.
Just use the floppy.
Yeah, and the floppy is 3 inches, right?
Yes, it's 3 inches, like most.
Amstrad PC. Right.
In this case, I added with hot glue in the top.
Yeah.
A 3.5 drive.
Yeah, more compatible.
Yes, total compatible.
Another question about this machine is the mechanic keyboard, right?
Oh, the keyboard.
Let's see on the camera.
It's quite dirty.
Yeah, quite dirty, but it's very solid keyboard, right?
In reality, is the keyboard was good for the price, but compared, for example, to an IBM PC keyboard, it's cheap.
It's a cheap keyboard.
And feels cheap.
Yeah.
But they do the job.
What's the price of this machine in that year, in the 85?
I don't remember.
But it's a low cost PC, right?
It was a very low cost. It was sold as a word processor system. It was sold like that. You want to do a word processor, you get it. But it runs CPM. And CPM was the most popular operating system for 780 computers.
Yeah.
And was DOS before MS-DOS. Most 780 systems run CPM in some form. And you can do a lot of serious work with that. For example, you can run a compilers for Pascal or for Ford.
I have the price here. 2,065 euros in the time in September 85, and another aspect of this machine, I have this question for you: is a regular machine, average machine, or a master race machine for that period of time?
No, it was like Alan Sugar do most of the time. He just got obsolete hardware that was very cheap.
Very cheap hardware.
Build a computer around that and sold it for, like Alan Sugar say, for
all cheap materials.
Yes. Obsolete the CPU. The system was going out at the moment this started to sold.
Tremenda rata.
Sí.
Yeah.
Sí.
It's a rat. It's a rat boy.
Alan Sugar used to say, remember. I'll read that he said that to the engineers on Amstrad. Remember that we sold computers for the tracker and his wife.
Mm.
And his design options reflect that. The idea when they started the computer, they want the monitor to be placed in a vertical fashion like arcade systems, so you can get an A4 page in the full screen. But that seemed to be expensive, I don't know why, so they go with an horizontal setup right now. The screen is very sharp.
Yeah. Very neat image, right?
Yes, and do more than 80, and do like 80 columns.
Sí, 80 columns, right?
And that was a requirement for a professional text editing software.
And the color of the monitor is only green and black screen, right? It's monochrome only.
It's mono only.
It's the only variant.
Yes, it's the only variant.
Yeah.
This line was quite successful. It sold a lot of systems.
It's all in one computer, right?
Yes.
Because you have all hardware, on the monitor.
Yes, the printer, for example, is the most simplistic thing ever. It don't even have a serial port or parallel port. The printer have its own custom port that goes straight to the system and drain the 24 volts and use for power from the system.
Uh-huh. And this machine have a standard connection? I see the keyboard connection is not standard.
No.
But floppy connection and another connection that you put in this machine?
No, the floppy drive was have an option for a second floppy drive.
Yeah, external floppy. Second floppy drive in here in the monitor.
Yes, right. Internally. The only expansion connector, apart from the printer connector, that it was only for that printer model, it have an edge connector on the back.
Edge connector on the back? No, don't show it. Don't show it anyway. Uh-huh. You have a C, edge connector. And what do you use this edge connector?
There was a lot of options for there, do by third party companies.
Uh-huh.
For example, you can get an AMX mouse interface, you can get a parallel printer port option, serial ports.
But this edge connector is not a custom edge connector, it's a standard edge connector.
No, it's just an edge connector.
Ah.
It's the edge of the PCB, like the ZX Spectrum expansion port.
Edge
connector.
Right. Is the Astra edge connector compatible?
No.
Yeah,
this computer have nothing to do with the CPCY.
This computer is have not to do with compatible.
No, this don't have anything to do with the CPCY in any way.
Well, and the software of this machine, we have here a Livingston Supongo again for this Astra PCW. And what other programs have in this computer?
Well, now you mentioned about the game.
Yeah.
We still didn't go to that part, but there are quite a few games for the system, and if you consider this a text processor, you think how there are so many games. And the case seems to be that this computer was used as a development system to develop software for the ZX Spectrum. Seem to some programmers will code in this
and
transfer it to the Spectrum and run the software. And that have the effect that you already have a running game that will work on the system.
Yeah.
And they just finished the game and also sold the game for the Spectrum and sold a version for the PCW.
Yeah.
There are a few, for example, they acquired a few titles. You have Soviet, the game for...
Yeah.
You have
HeroQuest, Comets,
Enchanter. My own writing, Ninja, the Last Ninja, the other Last Ninja,
Abadía del Crimen, Camel,
Lancelot,
Mutant Sound,
this all software,
all pirate.
These are all backups of my original game collection. I have a camera, but I can swear that I have it stored on a vault, a secret vault that nobody can see.
I failed the floppy disks, right? And then you say all software developed for Spectrum. Began in this machine.
No. Software no.
A few games. Developed in this machine for the ZX Spectrum.
Yes. Right? This is an example. Lewis Stone's Superboy 2. And it's quite a nice game, and it looks cool in monochrome.
Yeah, and very slow too. But anyway, you.
I don't think that goes any faster on the Spectrum.
Yeah, see, I think not. But another thing about this machine.
Well, it have 256K of RAM that will show up as a RAM disk.
You could expand the RAM in this machine.
Yes, the 512.
Yeah. The double.
The maximum amount. And that will give you a quite a big RAM disk where you can, for example, place your compiler.
Yeah.
And your working data, and you get a fast compiling times. For example, for text processing, you get fast saving time. Of course, if you turn off the computer, we'll lose the RAM disk.
But yeah.
For a developer, for example, was a great way to do software.
Yeah.
You copy your floppy to the RAM disk and were there. Using CPM, let you do all kind of things on this.
Like the standard Amstrad.
Yes, but you have the RAM disk included. That is quite big on the Amstrad. You have 128K on the test models.
Yeah, an application today for this machine is only for. Nostalgic love.
Like for that we show up. There's not much you can do unless you are some kind of masochist that like to do text processing on the worst printer that I ever seen in my life, apart from the Coleco Adam printer. That
you
can get the king place on terrible printers.
And the user of Commodore 64. But maybe let's take a look. This another machine. This or you. You talk about another thing.
Well, we have here.
Yeah.
The other thing.
Let me put the camera here. This motherboard. What is this motherboard?
Well, this computer is another PCW.
Yeah.
That I have a, I found a spare board on a.
Mira ahí para poder.
On a flea market.
Yeah.
And do a.
You adapt this machine for this case.
Yes. And it's now is independent from the monitor. You can connect it to any TV you want.
Oh, because you separate the motherboard for the monitor, right? And put in this case.
No, I found just a bare PCB.
Yeah.
And decided to make something out of it in place of letting in a drawer.
I
just build the computer for that. This. Another good thing about that, I installed a John B's IDE controller in here, so they have an IDE hard drive.
What is this? It's
an IDE controller for the PCW.
What do you do with this controller?
You can run CPM and have like 20 partitions or 5 meg partitions and copy. Do the same things you can do from floppy, but from ID faster.
Okay.
And you don't have to be swapping floppings. I done an adapter so you can plug the composite output to a TV because the motherboard don't do composite. There is no composite output on the motherboard. You have to build a small adapter.
You put adapter to see this machine to take a RCA output, right?
Yes, you can on a small board.
Yeah.
It's only you have a logic gate and a transistor, and that allow you to connect the
an adapter to
the PCW to any TV that have composite. Of course, you only have Luma. There is no color.
Okay. You don't have a mod to see this computer in color because it's made monochrome,
yes,
right?
Yes, there's nothing you can do about that. I got a lot of help from people on the Amstrad forums.
Now we'll connect the machine to see in the grammar.
Yes, for example, we have this connected to the screen capture device that Sebastian had in his computer, and that was a great way to capture but you can't do that on the answer.
Right. We see here in the picture of this computer.
Another side effect of don't having any ROM on the board.
Yeah.
That you will have to boot from a floppy, even if you have the IDE drive.
Because this machine don't have room.
Exactly. All this hardware was developed by Sean B from the AMSAL forum.
Yeah.
You can see here is CPM. And as you can see, I can do a C+, and we go to the hard drive. Here is one of the hard drive partitions.
Here, take a look.
And I have, for example, I think it's in the E partition. No, no leo nada de lo que sale ahí, está muy chico.
¿No lees? Para, ahí yo te veo. Ahí.
Ah, no.
Ah, ahí sí?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, indeed.
Well, I see in the picture a DOS.
Similar OS.
CPM was where MS-DOS was inspired from it, to say it kindly.
It's a clone of MS-DOS.
No, MS-DOS.
It's a clone of this.
CPM.
Okay.
CPM is before MS-DOS?
Yes, CPM was...
For that year.
Well, CPM was the standard operating system from most 780 computers.
780, right? It's for Bill... It's the same as of this man of Computer Chronicles?
Yes, of course. It's from Digital Research.
The Digital Research? I don't remember.
Gary Kilman.
Gary Kilman. This? Yeah. I remember now. And
of course, was what IBM wanted was to get CPM from here,
and
where they were development of the IBM PC. They go to him to ask for the OS, but from some reason he say no.
Because that day with he reunited with IBM is the wife Brida.
Yes, it was his wife. What happened was the IBM guys just got there and asked for she to sign some NDA contracts just to start talking about it.
I don't know the fact that the wife managed the company.
Yeah,
managed the compatibility of the...
It was a small company.
Yeah.
It was a small company. But that day he wasn't...
But managed a lot of money.
It was not as big as you can imagine. They make money, but it was not something like Microsoft. They don't sell so many copies of CPM.
And another thing we'll see to this?
No. It's just showing up the RAM disk and the stuff. There's nothing fancy here. It's just CPM.
Okay. Let's take a look at this another PC. Let's change the camera and give me a second to put the camera in the right position.
Vamos a ver la cámara.
Thank you.
Now we see another PC. This is Amstrad PC 12640. And what is that PC? It's for the same year of the before computer. I don't remember, but it's the same period of time. Let me check. Yeah, is for 86, 1 year later.
There's a big difference between this series of computer from Amstrad. This one is a PC compatible.
Yeah.
The PCWB is a 780 based system. Here you can run IBM software, MS-DOS software. In fact, now you were you just mentioned Gary Kilman.
Yeah.
Kilman. About what transpired about the operating system of this computer. When Amstrad first is going to launch the first model, the PC 112. They contact Microsoft to purchase licenses for MS-DOS for the computer.
Yeah.
But they also contact Digital Research, because Digital Research got the CPM operating system, ported it for 2086 CPUs Intel.
Yeah.
And then they make it MS-DOS compatible. And there's DOS Plus, a compatible MS-DOS to MS-DOS from Digital Research. So
this is a CPM or is
no,
a DOS?
It's DOS. But the OS that come with the machine, with the computer at first, was a Digital Research DOS Plus.
That was a modification of original DOS of Microsoft.
No, sorry. What I mean is that Amstrad approached Microsoft and Digital Research. Microsoft charged way too much for MS-DOS.
Yeah.
But Digital Research were quite willing to get their pounds down and lower the price. Much, much cheaper than Microsoft. Because Digital Research have converted CPM into DOS Plus and have made it compatible to Microsoft software. The story reverts now. Digital Research have to do an operating system compatible to MS-DOS to compete. So they load the DOS Plus on the systems. And also they will load a GEM, the GUI, GEM GUI on the system.
It's the same of the Atari ST?
Yes, it's the same. Of course, you can't run software from one on another. They run on different CPUs and computers. But this is the same.
Put the keyword to.
Yes.
Put the keyword here.
Yes, yes.
Give
me a second.
Good. And what is the technical information about this computer?
Well, it's just an 8086 system. 8 MHz, 640K of RAM. It have one 5.25 floppy drive, 360K. There is an option for a second floppy drive, or you can get it in this case. This model is the HD20, that you can get it with a hard drive as an option.
Yeah.
Also, this computer is a Schneider system.
It's a Germany version of
yes,
the Amstrad.
Yes, yes. It doesn't have anything to do with the Schneider beer, I suppose.
Yeah.
But some people, this was sold in Germany exclusively. And as you can see, the keyword is in German layout. This could work.
Let me put the camera at this keyword. And I see another thing interesting about this keyword is this have a connector of the joystick, a serial connector, right?
And a digital joystick connector indeed. It's a DB9 port.
Yeah.
And will take an Amstrad joystick or any Atari kind of joystick.
Mechanical keyboard, like the before machine.
Yes.
But I feel this keyboard is more professional between the two keyboards.
It have a different keyboard layout.
Yeah.
Yes, it's different keyboard layer, yes. For sure.
But the keyboard mechanism is the same. The difference is the placement of the keys. So.
Yeah, you have more keys here than before.
And they do weird things like adding control and alt in here.
Yeah, for more compatibility with DOS, right?
Yes, of course. This keyboard is similar to the IBM keyboard. Okay. But it's not identical. They place the keys in other places. For example, this is not where the keyboard layout on the IBM XT have these keys.
Don't work in the same way, you say?
Yes, they are not compatible. You can't plug this keyboard on a PC, and you can't plug a PC keyboard on this system.
Oh, okay. You don't.
You can't. They will not work.
Okay, don't work in this machine. So, this price of this PC in comparison with Tandy 1000 SX is, let me check here, is the Tandy cost
it may be better if you show the table there, because I'm not gonna get it.
Oh, sorry that.
Maybe you open the web page on the computer, maybe best. Abrir a
Here, let's take a look on the technical aspect about these two machines, Tandy 1000SX and Amstrad PC. And we see the price about these two machines and
The Amstrad is quite cheaper. You can get the complete system, including the mouse, keyboard, yeah. Monochrome display for less money that Tandy will charge for just the bare computer without monitor.
And I see in this technical information these two machines are very similar, right?
Yes.
In technical aspect.
Right? Yes, the Tandy have a better sound because it have a sound chip on board. It have the same kind of sound chip that the Master System, Sega Master System.
The Tandy.
And yeah. Also you get a 16 color mode on 320x200 the resolution. You can get 16 color games like on an HGA computer in any CCA monitor.
And the Robocop of Tandy is amazing.
Oh yeah. It have the best graphic and music.
The best bot of Robocop, yeah, the version.
The PC in this case is the PC 1512. This model also have Plantronics compatibility. You can do 16 color modes also in DOS using this. Much better than standard CCA.
Is game compatibility with DOS?
Sorry.
You have DOS game with run in this machine?
Yes, of course you can run. This computer is almost 100% compatible with the IBM PC. You can run any IBM PC software on it, no problem.
So if you boot this machine, you boot a IBM compatible PC.
Yes, but you pay much less money.
Yeah,
it was much.
I don't know if today you pay much less. You pay before in that time, but right now
this system go quite cheap on eBay. They are not hard to find at all. What is hard to find is the color monitor option. Mostly these computers were sold with the monochrome monitor that was much cheaper than the color option.
Yeah.
And that is what I have here. I have just a monochrome monitor. And also this system have a lot of quirks. For example, the power supply is in the monitor.
What other machine have a power supply in the monitor? I don't remember. Much other system.
There might be others, but that is a quirk of this system. And of course, Alan Sugar do that to save money.
Yeah.
And this reflect on the price. This computer was quite cheap than the other system that were around on Europe, on even in the US.
So if you with this machine, you with this machine with monitor.
Yes, and also you got a mouse. The mouse was included on the system.
Yeah.
You got a complete system, and maybe you pay $300 less than you pay for a similar setup from other companies with a monochrome monitor.
Yeah. What other aspect we see in this machine? Mm. I see here we have a floppy drive, right? Three inch.
You're still showing up the table, or you are on...
let me...
Oh. No. This floppy drive was installed by myself. There was no option from Amstrad to get a 3.5 drive for the system.
Five inch, right?
Yes,
you have a 2.5 inch.
Yes, this is the HD20 model. It's supposed to go with a hard drive, a 20 megabytes hard drive included.
20 megabytes hard drive, right? Yes.
But it was non-working, I removed it.
Yeah. So, in this machine you have a 20 hard drive disk, internally, right?
Yes, you have here a 20 megabyte drive for the model HD20.
Yeah.
In this case, the drive was non-working. I installed an ISA card that have XT IDE on it. And we are booting from a compact flash device.
Yeah. This machine have a room?
Yes, of course. Yes.
Like Ali MPC compatible.
Well, now you mentioned that, it's quite interesting because this computer is an XT compatible system, but it have a BIOS. And the BIOS have batteries and will keep your time and date and other options that you have. For example, one option that you can store in the BIOS.
Yeah.
You can redefine what keys
keys are for the each button, right?
Exactly. This is a two-button joystick. This will support it, and you can define any keys you want for the joystick.
Yeah.
The problem is that most games will do their own keyboard routines, so the joystick will not work.
Yeah. And another question for you is. The port for the joystick is the same port for the mice, for the mouse?
No. The mouse go on the left side, as you can see there. And there is the mouse. You can get it on camera. It was out of the camera.
A rare mouse,
An ugly mouse.
Ugly, very ugly.
It looked like
a fruit mouse.
It looked like a Moawi statue from the Island of Pascua.
Yeah. let me put the Moawi here.
The mouse also is not a serial mouse. It's the Amstrad designed this port on this mouse.
Amstrad custom port.
Yes, you need to run the Amstrad mouse driver, or it will not work.
What other ports have in this machine? You have a mouse port, a serial port for the joystick, and I see
on
that
the back, on the back you have your standard ports. You have a parallel port and a serial port.
IBM compatibles.
Yes, included. Yeah. With the standard DB25 connector and DB9.
It have VGA output?
No. The system uses a connector that is supposedly only for the included monitor.
But you said before this machine have ISA ports, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you put
yes, you can throw
a
in
video card and...
But you are tied to the monitor forever because the power supply is in the monitor. You have to keep the monitor there. You can use another monitor, but the monitor will be with you
forever.
Until the monitor broke down and you can't use your computer anymore because you don't have a power supply. The power gets from the plug to the monitor, and then the monitor connect to the system and will take the power from the monitor.
What application have for this machine? What software will see in this machine?
The system includes DOS Plus and also GEM from Digital Research.
This is a shame. The same shames we see in the Atari ST.
Yes, it's indeed it's the same operating system. At the moment, I have installed a version that all this software was open source by Digital Research, the company that purchased Digital Research. I don't remember what, but the code is free. So the guys, some guys have picked up this code and fixed it. For example, Digital Research was sued by Apple at some moment, and they asked them to remove the trash can and the movable windows. So the version of Shem that was included with the system have two non-movable windows here and here.
Yeah.
And the trash can was not there, and there's no desktop. You can do the same, but the desktop is not quite as nice as this one. The first version was like this, how we're looking at it now.
I will see too, it's a crispy image for the monitor, right? It's very nice.
Mm. Very sharp.
The MDA monitor, this is an Hercules compatible mode.
Yeah.
So we'll do a 720 for 348 resolution.
Let me check the resolution let's take a look.
No, you will not find it.
You don't find it. Here.
Oh no, that is the mode for the color. No, for the color monitor.
Ah, right.
But this is a monochrome monitor. But this that is 720. It's a very high resolution, but it will only do a 1-bit call. Like the mono mode in the Atari ST.
Yeah. Another thing, question for you is games. What games we play with this machine?
Oh, you can play all those games that work on Hercules monitors. In this case, using the MD monitor.
And what is the limit for games for this machine? Is games compatibility with 286?
8086. Intel?
Yeah,
this is an 8086 Intel. Yeah. We'll run any software that is DOS compatible that will support 8086 and 640K of RAM. Most early games will work fine. You can run Zack McCracken, Maniac Mansion. You can run
Duke Nukem 1,
yes, yeah. 2 maybe. And also you can run other games like
Dota Turbo Challenge.
No.
It's amazing.
You are asking too much.
Yeah.
Lotus Turbo Challenge, I think, is VGA.
Yeah, it's VGA, I think. And this machine has two original software, right?
Yes.
They have. And what is the software have this machine?
Sorry?
What is.
Decime en español, sorry.
El software que tiene esta máquina solo para ella.
Ah, there is none.
No.
There is none.
It's a
DOS clone, and we run DOS software. You have some games that have native support for this, like the Ocean version of RoboCop that sold in Europe. It supports the joystick, for example. There is a single game that used the Plantronic mode.
Yeah,
you can get in 16 color. On the color monitor,
not this one.
And you have none. There is nothing special about this computer.
It's only specialist. The Astro computer, nothing more.
It was cheap. It was cheap.
Right. So, what's next? What is the next computer we'll see tonight?
Oh, we have that portable thing there. Oh,
this portable, this compact machine. Oh.
I have to make space for that thing.
No,
it will not fit on this desk. Maybe move the camera there and you show it after.
Okay. A ver.
Ven para acá. Vamos a ver si.
Mostré la voz, Eva.
¿Sí? Okay. Vos lo hablas y yo lo vamos a hablar.
Es cierto, ¿no? Se ve como azul.
Sí.
Se ve como azulado. Igual no se lee un azul.
Bueno, y acá... machine we see in this camera?
That is the Amstrad PPC 640. It's a portable computer.
Yeah.
Portable, and but you have to have an electric plug close.
What is the weight of this machine?
It is heavy. It's an early portable computer.
Early portable computer. It's like a compact early computer, right?
Yes. Yes, it's compact. There is an option for use D batteries.
Yeah.
I think it takes like 20 D batteries on the bottom, but I think it will run like 2 hours using 20 D batteries. So Amstrad just drop from the marketing the. Just remove from the marketing the mentions to being able to use it with batteries, because the runtime was terrible. I can't imagine how expensive it could be in the 80s to purchase all the diesels. This thing need to run 2 hours. No, se va a dejar. Despacito.
Guys.
It's a very bizarre system. I never seen another portable that worked like this. That you open the keyboard from the main system and then tilt the monitor. It's just plain weird. Here is the power supply for it. You need this thing to run.
Power supplies have
13 volts. Mm-hmm. And all the voltages will be generated internally.
Yeah.
It have a modem. This computer have a modem. Under that small cover in the middle,
yeah,
is the modem cable. Pop up the cover.
Yeah. And I see you have. What is this?
Left that cable in there, we'll never be able to let it inside that hole again.
Sorry guys, sorry.
I have seen a lot of guys on eBay that sold these computers that they just fix it like this and picture the computer like this because they don't even get so that this damn thing should be going. Is the correct configuration.
Right.
And it have two floppy drives, two 720 floppy drives in
where?
Its side.
Here. Yes. Two floppy drives here.
Yes. Internal modem, 640K of RAM,
yeah,
and 8086 CPU. The internal display is CCA compatible. You can plug an external monitor.
Yeah.
The internal monitor is terrible. It's monochrome, 1-bit color. There is no backlight display.
It's like a Game Boy Color.
Yes,
monitor.
It's like a big Game Boy display.
Yeah.
And it's absolutely terrible. If you don't are sit under the sun, or you have a very good light source, you will see anything. And probably most people will just run this thing on an external monitor. They will fold the computer and take it home. Maybe you can get a monitor in the office and another in your house. That is the cable. You have the British phone plug. It's weird. Quite a weird thing. Yeah. And using that, you supposedly you can go on a hotel, for example. And if you are ahora meter ese cable de ahí de vuelta me va a tomar 3 años. Yo no lo quería sacar. For example, if you were what is the name of a guy that work on the news? Alguien que trabaja en las noticias, ¿cómo se dice el reportero? No sale el nombre.
I don't know.
Well, you can go to a hotel, plug it on the phone line, yeah. and get some data you need, or you go get some news to the corporate center, or connect to a remote terminal, and that was the use for this thing.
It's a pre-internet connection.
And was cheap. It was also a very cheap system, and used obsolete technology.
Like Alan Sugar,
go on an old CPU, old parts that nobody was using at the time anymore for cheap, and he built these portable computers. I never know of anyone that have worked on one of these. This, for example, was like new and seemed to be never used. I suppose the guy that purchased it at this time don't like it very much.
Yeah, it's a very rare machine, right?
No, it's not so rare. You can get it them cheap on eBay in reality. It's not such a rare. It's the design of how the cable falls and how you carry it is very special. I never seen another portable like this.
But in eBay, with this condition, you see much like that?
No, I think in eBay you maybe get it too. For $200, for example, $200 American.
Yeah, and I see two models of this machine, right? Mm-hmm.
There are two models.
What is different with another model?
The first model is the 520 model. It has less RAM, of course.
Yeah,
500, and don't have a mod.
This is the best version of the two.
Yes, indeed. It have a very a bizarre expansion connector on the back. Fold the screen and the keyboard. Sí. Open the door. Yes.
So down?
Yes, down.
Yeah.
And there you have all your expansion connectors.
What is this expansion?
There is the phone connector. First is the modem. The first connector is the modem.
Yeah.
And the other. You have your There. That is the modem. The cover that you open first is to store the cable only. You plug the phone line in there. Then you have that one is an ISA connector in 2 dB in a DB25. That one is
yeah.
is an expansion connector. It was never used.
Yeah. What is this Pentel? I don't know what is this Pentel.
Another thing I will show you today is the manual, the answer portable PC, PPC 512, and the other model, this model we see here is the answer PPC 614, and we see a fundamental using of the answer PC computer is a very nice, very complete manual. With we'll see technical information about this machine, like the components of the machine, the power adapter, the keyboard, the LCD monitor, the control of volume, contrast, indication, like the compatibility 3.5 inch and car battery adapter is compatibility with car adapter. And we'll see another thing about this machine is battery compatibility, and we see in this manual we need six batteries 2A. I think is here the component, and we see this machine is compatibility with external monitor, right? This Peritel is for the monitor. Era compatible con el monitor ese Peritel. Ahora descubrimos este asunto. And
the manual is in the box.
The manual is in the box. And with this machine,
you get a bag.
A very dirty bag.
No, that use your sinar fungi. But that is common. This bag will peel, the plastic will start to peel off.
Yeah.
And will start to get black in color. But it's not dirt. It's just that these things get like that.
Yeah. But it's a very nice bag. Anyway.
Very nice bag, yes.
Another thing about this machine, you maybe lost to mention.
I don't see anything more to say about it, but it seemed to have sold quite good. So I suppose because it was a cheap. Let me show the battery compartment.
Okay.
That will be fine. Oh, you were able to close this thing. For example, this computer have to use plug up all the time.
Yeah.
And in case you are crazy enough to use it with batteries, here is the battery compartment, and it takes 2 for 10 diesel batteries.
Puedes pararlo para verlo. 10 batteries?
10 diesel batteries, the big ones, the big batteries.
Type D. Whoa, oh my gosh.
And that will get you 2 hours of work time. So you have to use them. Use them wisely.
Whoa, that is a lot consume of battery.
Yes, for that reason the battery option was there, but never was used.
It's not available for today.
No, it was not available at the time. You have at the time you have to go and purchase 10D batteries, and that was very expensive. And was not an option.
Well, people, it's all for today. Many thanks to White Ranger and Bizarre King for the company of today. And we'll see you next time in this channel. Bye for now.